Enter Dr. Guinevere Eden, a researcher at Georgetown Medical School who's studying the biological signs of dyslexia.
Several studies have determined the differences in the brains of people with and without dyslexia. So the message there is we know it's biologically based.
By using MRI scans to map Jonathan's brain activity, Dr. Eden and her colleagues can show how different areas of the brain react in struggling readers like Jonathan.
Can you press that for me?
When typical readers do a phonological task, the left hemisphere activity is much more impressive than what we see in the right hemisphere. And then we compare that to people who have a history of dyslexia, and we find that they don't activate those areas as strongly.
Dr. Eden sees the potential for one day using MRIs to diagnose dyslexia very early in young children. But there's more to these brain studies than just gathering data for the future.
One of the things about the brain research that I think actually helps these children is they come in for these studies, they get to see their brain, and we explain to them the reason you have struggled with the reading is because of something that's a little bit different about your brain, and we're hoping that through reading interventions we're going to make up for that difficulty.
Jonathan understands that now. He received good intervention in time, and it's made a world of difference.
Now Jonathan loves school. Jonathan actually said to me one weekend, he can't wait for Monday to come. I'm like, why? He said, so I can go to school. I'm like, wow.